Ohm's law can be verified both by qualitatively and quantitatively. First, let us talk about the qualitative verification of Ohm's law. For that, it is very simple. If you take one cell and a bulb is connected across it, and note down the brightness of the bulb. Let it be B1. Now, instead of one cell, let's take two cells of the same potential difference. Then what happens to the brightness of the bulb? It is an obvious answer that the brightness is increased. So here, B2, the brightness in the bulb when two cells are connected is greater than B1, that is the brightness in the bulb when one cell is connected. So it clearly indicates when what we are doing actually here. Initially, suppose if I take a cell like this, it is 1.5 volt. When 1.5 volt, then this is the brightness, and 3 volt, because it is connected in series one after the other, then it is brightness is increased. So it clearly tells us that when V is increased, the brightness is increased, the current is causing the brightness, therefore I is also increased. Let's go through the activity by increasing the voltage. When we increase the potential, the current is also increased. Now let us see. Obviously, seeing is believing. Here, I took one battery eliminator. This battery eliminator can supply variable voltage. By switching this, we can increase the potential difference. And I have connected this battery eliminator across the bulb. Now what you will observe is, if the potential difference is low, then the brightness of the bulb is also low. When we increase the potential difference, the brightness will be increased, which proves the Ohm's law. Now let's begin. Let's begin with the very low voltage. Now you can observe the brightness of the bulb at 1.5. Now let me increase this value. Now you can see the brightness of the bulb is also increased. Now by increasing the potential difference, furtherly the brightness of the bulb is increased. So if you go on increasing the potential difference, of course the bulb can sustain a particular potential difference because it was designed for a particular potential difference only. Beyond that, if you increase the potential difference, the bulb may go off. So now let us repeat the experiment. The very fundamental concept of this experiment is to understand Ohm's law qualitatively, not quantitatively we are measuring it, simply qualitatively. When we increase the potential, the brightness, which is caused because of electric current, is also increased. So I am increasing the potential now, the glow is also increased, now that it has gone.
If you want to verify Ohm's law, we require one battery eliminator or a cell to note down the current, one ammeter, a resistance across which we wanted to study the relation between the potential difference and current. So this is voltmeter. Now to get more values, we have to make use of a variable resistance which is known as rheostat, and we will have one switch, of course, so that battery is not consumed when we are not taking the readings. Now after inserting a plug, the circuit will be completed, and then we have to take the readings of the current through the ammeter, potential difference through the voltmeter, and we observe the ratio of potential difference to the current, which is nothing but resistance. We are taking only one wire and we are taking different values of voltage and current. In all the cases, you have to get the same or more or less same, because sometimes experimental limitations, because of which you may be getting small variation for one reading to the other. So here we'll have to note down first what is the current, then that reading you have to take, and then what is the potential difference, and then V1 by I1. So like that, minimum some 6 readings are to be obtained. Let's do this activity.
The apparatus required for Ohm's law: battery eliminator, RSL, milliammeter, a voltmeter, a resistance coil, and a rheostat. So you can see, when I am moving the key on the rheostat, both the readings of voltmeter and milliammeter are continuously increasing. Now at any one particular point, if you take, for example here, the reading of milliammeter is approximately 100 and the reading of voltmeter is 0.2 volt. 0.2 volt, whereas the corresponding current is 100 milliamperes. To calculate the resistance for this particular reading, R is equal to V by I. Here V is 0.2 and I, it is in milliamperes, therefore 100 must be multiplied by 10^-3. So now if 10^-3 goes to the numerator, it becomes 1000, and in the denominator it is 100. Therefore, these two zeros will be cancelled, and finally, we can get the answer as 2 ohms. So, like this, for 0.2, then 0.4, 0.6, like that, you have to take the readings, and continuously you have to calculate the values of resistance. And finally, we observe that the resistance value is always same. Second reading we can observe at 200 milliamperes, which is the voltage reading is 0.4 volt. Now for 300, it is supposed to be 0.6. Let us see whether it is. So at 300 milliamperes, the 0.6 volt. So every time the ratio is coming out to be 2 ohms only. So in this way, one can verify the Ohm's law experimentally.
If you plot a graph between the voltage and the current, then the graph obtained should be a straight line, as the two V and I are in proportion with each other. And from this graph also, we can obtain the resistance anywhere. If you take, this is change in current and this is change in voltage. So change in voltage by change in current. Here, if you consider that this is theta, it would be base by perpendicular, therefore cot theta. This gives us the value of resistance. If you change the quantities, potential on this and current on this, you will get tan theta as resistance.